Hey, book of the daytime. Welcome to my kitchen. You're gonna be seeing a lot of bun Miss Prifty if I'm not coming in to work. Hunter's just waking up from his nap and we're gonna kind of ignore him to see if he goes back down. He might make a guest appearance. So, today we're reading Dog Loves Books. How cute he is. Oh, it's my first book of the day back. I'm so excited. Kind of weird, though, to be in my kitchen doing it. Dog loved books. He loved the smell of them, and he loved the feel of them. He loved everything about them. I'm going to do the best I can to show you the cute little doggy. Yeah. Dog loved books so much that he decided to open his own bookstore. He unwrapped, unpacked, and stacked the books ready for the grand opening. Look at his little, like, marching. Oh, love dogs. Hunty, do you like dogs? We have one. You better like them. When the day of the grand opening finally came, Dog had a bath, dried his fur, blew his nose, and threw open the door to greet his new customers. Seems to be like a pattern. A lot of lists going on. Every page there seems to be a list of something. But there was no one there. So Dog tried to keep busy. And then, we'll do it that way. A lady came into the store. "I'll have a tea with milk and two sugars," she said. "I'm sorry," said Dog, "but this is a bookstore. I only sell books." The lady walked out. Dog was alone. He waited and waited. Then a man came into the store. Oh, look at his body. Remember we talked about your body can reflect how you're feeling? Oh, ears up, excited. To ask for directions. Oh, that's a letdown. Look at his body now. Oh, ears are down. Hey, trying to read. Quiet in the class. When he left, Dog was downhearted. But not for long. He wouldn't wait a moment more. Dog fetched a book from the shelf and began to read. When he read, he forgot that he was waiting. Do you want to come join? All right, wait a minute. When he read, he forgot that he was alone. Look at the dinosaurs. Hunter, it's a dinosaur book he's reading. We love dinosaurs. When he read, he forgot that he was in the bookstore. Look at the details being added as he keeps reading and getting more and more into the book. Remember making that movie in your mind? And when one adventure ended, Dog simply took another book down from the shelf. And there's some friendly dinosaurs. A new adventure began. So Dog was somewhere else altogether when a customer came into the store to ask for a book. Dog knew exactly which ones to recommend. Oh, Hunter wants a book. Dog loves books. But most of all, he loves to share them. Oh. Oh, and then look at the dinosaurs reading. All right, let me show you. Rory, come here. Come show my doggy. And then you can come over too. Here's my doggy. I don't know if she loves books, but she lets her mama read at night and she lays next to her. And at the pool, when we read at the pool, this is Rory. Hi, let's get Hunty Bear because he's cranky pants. What? You need to be sleeping. It's sleepy time. Hi, you want to go say hi to the kids? Come on. You're probably going to cry. Ooh, let's turn him around. Oh, boom. It's Hunty Bear. Oh, give him a smile. Give him a smile. Say, sorry, my mommy's staying home with me. Miss you guys. All right, until next time. Bye.